I want to bring in the CEO of Robinhood, Vlad Tenev, is with us right now, and we appreciate you joining us on a day where there are so many questions. And as Melissa just said, there are, frankly, as you know, a lot of angry customers out there and a lot of questions about what took place and the decisions that you made to limit so many of your customers' ability to buy stocks like GameStop. Questions about whether you have a liquidity problem, whether you're trying to protect them from themselves, whether Citadel did this. Explain what happened today.
Thank you for having me on the show again, Andrew. So what happened today was, as you pointed out, we had to make a very difficult decision. It's been a challenging day. We made the decision in the morning to limit the buying of about 13 securities on our platform. So to be clear, customers could still sell those securities if they had positions in them, and they could also trade in the thousands of other securities on our platform. So it was a difficult decision, and that's what we had to do as part of normal operations.
But explain then, why did you do this? Did the SEC call you and tell you you had to do this? Was there a problem inside the company in terms of liquidity, in terms of the amount of deposits that you had to put in front to the exchanges? What led to this?
Sure. And let me explain exactly how this works. First of all, I want to address some of the misinformation that's been out there, because there's a lot of it. We absolutely did not do this at the direction of any market maker or hedge fund or anyone we route to or other market participants. The reason we did it was because Robinhood is a brokerage firm. We have lots of financial requirements, including SEC net capital requirements and clearinghouse deposits. So that's money that we have to deposit at various clearinghouses. So some of these requirements fluctuate quite a bit based on volatility in the markets, and they can be substantial in the current environment where there's a lot of volatility and a lot of concentrated activity in these names that have been going viral on social media. So we're really in unprecedented times. And in order to protect the firm and protect our customers, we had to limit buying in these stocks. And to be absolutely clear, go ahead.
But it sounds to me, though, that you're suggesting that there was a liquidity problem inside the firm. And my question about that then raises all sorts of new questions about whether there's a systemic issue underneath the system and underneath the company unto itself.
No, there was no liquidity problem. And to be clear, this was done preemptively. So we did this proactively, and thousands of other securities remain tradable on the platform. Customers that held these positions were able to sell them, and we're doing what we can to allow buying and to remove these restrictions in the morning. But also, you might have seen Robinhood has been the number one app in the App Store overall. So we have seen unprecedented interest due to the fact that finance has been culturally relevant in a way that hasn't been before, and these stocks are going viral on social media. And I think it's really interesting to juxtapose against some of the other questions that we've been having before this. Of course, Robinhood stands for everyday investors. From the very beginning, we have stood for investors, opening up access and giving them the ability to trade commission-free in whatever they want. And we've gotten a lot of criticism that, you know, maybe there should be more restrictions. So it pains us to have had to impose these restrictions, and we're going to do what we can to enable trading in these stocks as soon as we can.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.